Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm continuing the series on how to make money with low or no content books on Amazon KDP. And if you want to see the next videos in the series, you can just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to make the file that we just made in the last video and upload it to Amazon KDP. All right, let's get started. Now, to sell on Amazon KDP, you'll need to have a KDP account. So go to kdp.amazon.com and then sign in with your normal Amazon account. Now, Amazon does not like you making another account just to sell Amazon KDP books. So make sure that you use the one that you already have. When you sign up for your KDP account, you'll have to put in all this information like your address, your phone number, your bank account details so they can pay you if you sell some books, and just a lot of other things. So you'll need to get all that done. You can do it before you even are ready to start selling books at all. It's a good idea to do it now just so you have access to some of the tools that they have. Now I'll head over to kdp.amazon.com and I'll sign in. And then I'll see this screen. And we want to create a new book. I'll choose paperback. And here's where I'll enter my book title and all the information for my book. I'll put Be a Nice Human Notebook with Lines for Writing. Now in the book title and subtitle, you'll want to use your niche keyword, the one that we found when we used the Amazon Search Expander and the Keyword Research SEO tool extensions. Make sure that you don't do any keyword stuffing in here though. Only write everything once, and it's a good practice to make it readable. For the series, if your book is part of a series, you can add series details here, but most of the time, your book will not be part of a series. This is more for people who write fictional novels, like the Harry Potter series, for example. Edition number. I always leave this blank. You can read what counts as a new edition here, so take the time to read that if you think yours applies to this. For the author, you'll want to enter your first and last name, or a pen name. So I'm going to put Jada Williamson in here. Make sure it sounds like a name though. If you put Kindness Books or something like that, Amazon will not like that. So make sure it sounds like a real name. Contributors, you'll only need this if someone else contributed to your book. Since this is a low or no content book, you are probably not going to have contributors on your book. In the description area, this is where you can describe what your book is about. Customers can learn more about the type and size of book. You can bold certain parts, italicize, underline, and that kind of thing. And you can also change the source code if you want to do that. I'll make this first line bold. Now for publishing rights, you need to make sure that you own the copyright so you're not stealing this from someone else. I'll choose, I own the copyright and I hold necessary publishing rights. And you can read more about that here. Public domain works are those that are over 70 years old and they're in the public domain. I never choose this option for a low content book. And then keywords. You're going to want to put in keywords that describe your book. So in our niche example, our keyword was dog lovers, gifts for men, pit bull. So we would want to put that keyword here if this book did apply to pit bulls, which it doesn't. Instead, I'm just going to describe the cover, what the niche is, which is kindness, and the background is nature theme. And then you can fill out the rest of these keyword areas with similar descriptive terms that describe your book. Now you'll need to choose two categories. So I'm going to go ahead and choose one. This will be a nonfiction book. I'm going to choose body, mind, and spirit. And sometimes it can be hard to choose a category. I just try to find one that's the most applicable to my book. So I'm going to put general here. And then under literary collections, there is actually a category for diaries and journals. So I'm going to choose that one as my second category. And I'll save that. And then I'll choose low content book, which is what this one is. And my journal doesn't have any adult content, so I'll say no here. And I'll save and continue. Now, since we have a low content book, we're going to publish without an ISBN, but you can also use your own ISBN. And if you want to do this, you would have to purchase an ISBN on your own, but then you could enter the numbers here. I don't really think this is necessary, so I'm just going to go ahead and go with that one. The publication date, I always leave this blank, so my live on Amazon date will be used. And then for print options, I'm going to have a black and white interior with white paper. I'm going with 6x9, no bleed. This is the interior. And then the paperback cover finish, I want it to be matte instead of glossy. Now I'm going to upload my paperback manuscript. And this is the one we made in the last video. Here's my interior, so I'll upload that. And then I'm going to upload a cover I already have. And this is a print ready PDF, which is what I want. I'll upload my cover file, and that is this one right here. And this takes a little bit of time. Now, if your cover includes a barcode, you'll want to check this box here, but mine doesn't. This means that Amazon will add a barcode to the back of my book. And then I'll choose Launch Previewer. And this part takes a little while. Okay, so it's ready, and now I can see what this is going to look like. The barcode will be here. And then the rest of it looks good. And then I can flip through all 100 pages to see how they look. We'll go to the last few pages, and this looks good. So I'll approve, and then I'll scroll down a little bit. And this is where you can kind of double check everything. Okay, this says that my printing cost is going to be $2.15. So that's how much Amazon charges for printing the book and all that stuff. Then I'll go to save and continue. And then we'll scroll down, and here's where we can enter the price that we want to charge for this book. I think I want to charge $8.25. Now, if I charge this much, my royalty for this book will be $2.80 if it sells in the US. If it sells in these other places, it will be a little bit different depending on the exchange rate. I'll scroll down, and in the terms and conditions section, it says, if you publish this, you're basically agreeing to the KDP terms and conditions. Now these, I would definitely read these to make sure you're not violating them in some way. It's just a good idea before you sell on any platform to really know what their restrictions are. And then if you want to request a book proof, you can do that. You can choose request proof. And if you do this, it'll bring you to a screen where it tells you how much they charge to send you a copy of your book. And then once you're all done, you can hit publish your paperback book. Now, once you click this button, it will go into a review queue where people at Amazon will look at it and make sure everything is good to go with it. Once it's approved by the review team, it'll go live on the site. And this usually takes anywhere from 5 to 7 business days. So that's it. With just a few simple steps, you can create and publish a low content book on Amazon KDP and start making money. All right, I hope you liked this video. And if you want to see the rest of the videos in this series, just hit the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.